Good morning, students, and welcome back to my online classes once again. Today we are here to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 13, direct and inverse proportion. So in this chapter only two exercises are there. First exercise is based on direct proportion only, and second one is in inverse. Okay, so now we have to know first in which area in our day-to-day life we use first proportion, that is the direct proportion, and where are the areas we need to apply inverse proportion. So direct proportion, how will you define direct proportion? Suppose two quantities x and y. We say x varies directly to y when ratio of the two quantities always remains same. I said ratio of the two quantities. Okay, it always remains same. Say commodities and its total cost. Commodities means any goods when you purchase from the market. Suppose cost of 5 pence is 40 rupees. This first condition, cost of 5 pence equals to 40 rupees. Now, if I reduce the pen number, so your price, total cost will be reduced or increased. So obviously it will be reduced. So cost, if I increase one side, say if I increase the pen number, I like to purchase more pens. Okay, then what to do? I have to pay more money. So one side is increased, another side also increased proportionately. Proportion is there. Proportionately it will be increased. And if I decrease one side, other side will be proportionally decreased. That situation is called direct. Okay, say price, commodities and price, then speed and distance. Suppose if you run your scooter 60 km per hour, you are covering say 150 km. Now instead of 60, if you increase your speed 80 km, then you will cover more distance. That means more speed, more distance. So in that situation, it is direct. Worker and work. Another situation is worker and work. Suppose you have deployed 10 people to dig a plot of earth. Okay, plot of land. 10 people. Now, so they have completed the tasks within a day. Okay, now instead of 10 people, if you reduce the people number, say 5 people, will they able to complete their tasks in one day? No, because you have reduced the people number, worker number, so time will also more, time will be more to complete the same tasks in a day. Okay, so earlier it was, I have told you, you have to complete the tasks in one day. I have given 10 people, they will be able to. Now second stage I am telling you, no, I will give you 5 people, they will not be able. Suppose people, each and every people doing their work properly. Okay, so now they will not be able to complete the task. So if we increase the people number, time we have to give more. Earlier it was one day, now they will take 2 days. Okay, because we have reduced just half, we have to make it double. So that product of the two quantities remains same. So inverse proportion, x and y, it will be varied inversely to each other when the product of the two quantities x and y will remain same. So inverse variation will start, I will say again. So first of all, you have to know the direct variation. So direct variations area, I told you, commodities and price, speed and distance, worker and work. If we deploy more worker, we will get more work. If we deploy less worker, you will get less work. That concept is the direct variation and is the area of use of direct variation. Okay, so now definition, direct variation. Write down all of you please, direct variation. Direct proportion or variation, same meaning, direct proportion. Two quantities two quantities, say x and y, vary directly to each other, if the ratio, I'm writing in capital letter, this is most important word, if the ratio of two quantities remain the same, remain the same every time. Every time. Jab bhi, when you will calculate this part, whatever it is, the ratio will remain same. Okay? We have to test with an example. Say, example. Now, earlier in class 7, we have done unitary method. Unitary method is nothing, that is the direct variation and inverse variation. Somewhere we have to find out the product, somewhere we have to find out the ratio. So in this case, unitary method, within 3 lines the sum will be completed. We will not write in, but in case of direct inverse variation in class 8, what we do, we will not write the 3 lines. We will just make a table and we will ask in your mind, which condition we are going to apply by getting the data. I have told you 3 areas: commodities price, speed, distance, worker, war. These are the example of direct proportion. Okay. So now, say, this 2 quantities. In exam, I will set this question this way only. I will give you X and Y. So, 20, 40, then 17, 34, then 14, 28. You have to test whether they follow direct variation is or not. So you see, I have written a capital letter ratio. Test it. Check whether follow direct variation or not. Check whether it follows direct variation, direct proportion or not. Direct proportion or not. So, number one, I have taken 20 by 40. So, cut 1 by 2. That means it is coming 1 by 1 is to 2. Who understood? Okay. 1 is to 2. B, 17 by 34, x by y, 17 by 34. If I cut, it is coming this 1 by 2, that means again 1 is to 2. C, 14 by 28. So if I cut, I am getting 1 by 2, that is 1 is to 2. In all cases, it is coming 1 is to 2, 1 is to 2, 1 is to 2. It means what? Whatever the data I have given, X and Y, they vary directly to each other. So, because ratio of these two data remains same in every cases. So, that's why I'm telling you, okay, this type of calculation we have to follow derivation. So, in exam, what will you do? First of all, you have come to know whether this from this example, whether you have to test, and I will give you this type of data, you have to test whether it follows direct variation or not. Direct variation also. So you will test this way, you will find out, because I have said ki direct variation, if the ratio of the two quantities remains same, two quantities ratio 1:2, 1:2, 1:2, then I will say yes, they vary directly to each other. Okay, and if I say, already I have given the answer, statement ki the x and y vary directly to each other. So then find the missing term. Find the missing term whether it follows direct variation or not. So this type of question I am also selecting. Have you written this one? Okay, you will pause the video and you will write down x and y. Okay, the data I am giving you, you have to find out the missing data by following direct variation rule. X 1 by 15, 1 is given, thereafter missing part 8, 36 and this one is 15. Okay, now you solve. So solution, what will happen? Always you have to take the 4 box. Okay, then what way you have to filter. It is wrong. Okay, so then it will be 5 by 15 equals to 8 by y. So 5y equals to 8 into 15. Okay, or y equals to 8 into 15 by 5, cut 3, that is coming 24. So that means here it will be 24 by following the direct variation rule. Here it will be 24. Now we have to find out this one. So I have to take this one as a box. Okay. So what to do? I am rubbing it. Whatever the value you are getting, you just note down and fill in the boxes in circle. Here this was one missing. Okay. Now take the second one. This one was missing, so I have got this value. So 8 by 24 now equals to x by 36. This one. So we have to follow direct variation. This is cross multiplication, linear equation. So 24x equals to 8 into 36, or x equals to 8 into 36 by 24. 3 8s are 24, 3 12s are x equals to 12. So that means the value will be 12 here. So this way we can find out the missing value. When the instruction given x and y vary directly to each other, we have to follow this one. Have you understood? This one. Now last one. Question number, this one you have to take, 12 by 36 equals to 15 by y. Now cross multiplication, 12y equals to 3 into 15, or y equals to 3 into 15 by 12. So by 12, okay, if I cut it by 3, this one, so it will be 4. Now here the answer is coming fraction. 15 and 4 is not being cancelled, so it will be 15 by 4 in bracket. Sometimes fraction may also come. So don't convert it to decimal, you will write down in fraction form only. How about this two? So case, question number, exercise this, question number 1A. What is this parking charge? 4 hours. 4 hours. What is the charge? ₹16. Okay. Therefore, ratio, find out. Ratio equals to 4 upon 16. If you cut, I am getting 15. That is 1:15. Okay. B. you have to find out all cases, and then you have to see whether it follows the direct proportion or not. Direct or not, that need to find out. Clear? So the second one, 8 hours, 100 rupees. 8 hours, 100 rupees. So therefore ratio is what? 8 upon 100. Cut by 4, 2, cut by 4, 25. So it is 2 by 25, that is 2 is to 25. Now see, 12 hours 140, 12 hours one rupees 140. So ratio equals to 12 by 140. If we cut by 2, 6, if we cut it by 2, 70, cut by 2, 3, 35, that is 3 is to 35. Similarly, if you find out the next one, so already you have seen, I have done 3 questions, A, B, C. First one, ratio is 1 is to 15, second one, 2 is to 25, third one, 3 is to 35. It means what? Can you say they vary directly to each other? No. So here, the hours and parking charges are not varying directly to each other. So you will find out the last one after that. Therefore, hours, parking hours and charges not vary directly to. Therefore, parking hours and charges are not varying directly to each other. This much you have to write down. I have calculated, and after that I have understood they are not varying directly to each other. Got it? Now second question, same way whatever I have done earlier. So they are giving the instruction ki parts of the red pigment and parts of the base color. When you paint a room, there will be a ratio of the pigments. So when all the color which you are bringing at home, it is in bucket, and that will be basically white. Now you have to give a particular color. Then how many color pigment will be dropped inside that drum, depending on the capacity of the drum. It may be a 4 liter can, it may be a 10 liter can, it may be 20 liters can. These three are basically available. So how many drops you have to put inside this drum? This is also direct variation. So if 4 liter cans requires say manloki 10 drops, then 8 liters will be just double, then 20 liters will be proportionately increased. So in this way we have to find out what will be the missing base pigment, that need to find out. Okay, you see question 2, red pigment. First you have to box, you have to draw a box, this one. Okay, in class 7 I think you have done it. During unitary method I have not followed. Parts inside, you have parts of red pigment and base, parts of base. One box, two box, 3, 4, 5. So here it will be 1 by 8. If one red pigment, that equals to 4.8 quantities of this base. Base color will be 8, and pigment should be 1. This is my ratio. Now, next time if I find out 4 pigment, if I drop 7 pigment, if I drop 20 pigment, if I drop 12 and if I drop 20 pigment, what will be the base color? What will be the volume of the base color that you have to find out? So first you have to find out this one. Always I told you, you have to take a 4 box. This is the base pigment is missing and is the parts of red pigment is given. Okay. 1 by 8 equals to 4 by base pigment. Base. Okay. So calculation. So B into 1, B equals to 8 into 4 or base equals to 32 pigments. 32 base pigment is parts of base, 32 parts. That means 32 times more you have to drop 32 parts. Now B, so now you have got 32 here, put in circle. You have to calculate 4 upon 32, if it is, then 7 upon B. So you have to find plus multiply. 4B equals to 32 into 7 or B equals to 32 into 7 by 4. Cut. So it will be 8. B equals to 56 parts. Then C, 56. Write down 56 here in circle. Now next is 7 by 56. Equals to 12 by B. So what will write down? So 7B equals to 56 into 12 equation, or B equals to 56 into 12 by 7. Cut 8, or B equals to 96 parts. So here it is coming 96. Put in bracket. What will be the last one? D. D1 is the 12 by 96. That equals to 20 upon B. So, 12B equals to 96 into 20. Or, 12B, 12 or B equals to 96 into 20 by 12. So 8 12 is 96 and B equals to 160 parts. So this is the answer. Got it? So if red pigment and base color, red pigment and base color vary directly to each other, and this is 160. So if I put 1 pigment, so I have to proportionately put 8 pigment. First condition is given. The second, 4 if I drop, then these all are missing. So following direct vibration, I am getting the base pigment, this will be how many? How many? What will it? Suppose it is 1 liter, then it will be 8 liter. If it is 4 liter, then it will be 32 liters. If it is 7 liter, then you have to put 56 liters. So, to mix that color. Clear? So, base pigment is a, this is the relation. Great. Write down first. Now, I am coming to question number 3. Question number, not 3, question number 4. Question number 4. Question number 4. What is this? A machine in a soft drink factory fills 840 liters in 6 months. 840 liters in 6 months. Clear? 840 liters in 6 hours. How many bottles will it fill in 5 hours? So, suppose machine is an instrument, his work capacity is fixed. If it requires, if it can fill 840 liters in 6 hours, how much it can fill in 5 hours? So what is happening? 8 hours, earlier it was 8 hours and filling capacity is 840. Now second time it is saying if 5 hours I am reducing time, so obviously it will feel less. Your time is less, feeling also less. When time is more, feeling will be also more. Understand my point? So this way you have to proceed. Let whatever the missing in statement sum you have to take it as a x. How many bottles will fill in 5 hours? Let the required number of bottle. Required number of bottles be x. So therefore you just drop make a box. We will not write down any statement here. This is a box method. You have to follow box method. Okay. So this is time, or even you can fill in capacity. Time fill in liter. Fill in liter, LTRS. So time is what? 8 hours. How much it fills? 6 hours. Time is 6 hours. Time is 6 hours. It fills 840 liters. Time is 6 hours. It fills X. Suppose it is not there. X may be here or here. No matter. Two quantity. One quantity is missing. That is I am taking as X. It is not necessarily X line will be should be here. First quantity, second quantity. Whatever the quantity is missing, I am taking as X. And we have understood this problem. If I increase the time, it can fill more. If I decrease time, it will fill less. That means that condition is direct variation. And in case of direct variation, we will find out the ratio. In case of direct variation, we will find out. That's why at the right side, you have to write down the logic. I have gone through the question, I have understood, and we are going to follow direct variation here. So what we write down? Here time and filling will vary directly to each other. Why? Suppose this exercise, all question will be direct variation. But at the time of examination, you don't know which question from which exercise I am giving you. So we have to study the question and we have to make sure this will be direct or this will be inverse. Okay. So therefore, we have understood the direct variation. You have to follow direct variation. 6 by 840 should be equals to 5 by x. Now, cross multiplication, it will come 6x equals to 5 into 840, or x equals to 5 into 840 by 6. Okay, cut. 170. So x equals to 700 liters. So it can fill in 5 hours 700 liters soft drinks. You understood? Proportionately decrease. Earlier it was 840. Due to less time, it can fill less liters also. 700. Clear? Now, I am coming to question number 5. A photograph of the bacteria enlarges 50,000 times, attaining a length of 5 cm as shown in the diagram. What is the actual length of bacteria if the photograph is enlarged 20,000 times only? So, increase the time, size also increase. Decrease the time, size also in your decrease the sign. So here also it varies directly to each other. Clear? Let the required length be x. Okay, so times at a length of 5 cm. Length and time 50-100 time. So length is 5 cm and times is 50,000 times 18 lakhs. And second is, if the in-laws time is there 20,000, what will be the actual length? Length is x. Here length and time, length and time vary directly to each other, directly to each other. This instruction we have to write down every time, because I am telling you this is the direct variation exercise, so all question will follow direct variation, no problem. But question is, at the time of examination, you don't know from which exercise I have given you. You have to go through the question, you have to understand ki what will be the my way of work. I will follow direct or inverse. You have understood it is a direct variation, that's why you are writing at the end. So after that, you follow the calculation part following direct variation rule. So therefore 5 by 5, 50,000 equals to x by 20,000. So now cross multiplication, 50,000 x equals to 5 into 20,000, or x equals to 5 into 20,000 divided by 50,000. 1, 2, 3, 4, cut, 5, cut, this cut. So x equals to 2 cm. So actual length of the bacteria is 2 cm. Got it? Note down it. Now, I am coming to question number 6. Question 6. What is this? The model of a sheep. The mast is 9 cm high, while the mast on actual sheep 8 meter. If the length of the sheep is 28 meter, then how long the model sheep will be there? You see, there is a model of sheep. If on ground, the sheaf height is 12, then the model height will be 9. Understood? On ground, the sheaf length is 12, height is 12, and model height is 9 cm. Now saying, if the actual length of the sheaf is 28 meter, then what will be the height of the model? So, if length is more, model height will be also more. Supposing a man, your geographical man, 1 mm equals to how mass? It is marked. 1 mm, 1 mm is equal to 50 km. So, from one distance to another distance, how many mm will be there? If you multiply, you get the accurate distance between the two places. Okay, same way, model height and the actual height, the ratio is always direct variation. Are you clear? So, we have to follow direct variation here. Whatever the value is not there, that will be taken as x. Let the height of the model, let the height of model be x. So write down here, model height actual height actual length model model height is, if the model height is 8-9 centimeter, actual is the 12. If the model height is, actual length is 28, this is the here, model height and actual length. Here, model height and actual length vary directly to each other. Directly to each other. Are you clear? The guideline you have to write down. After that, you have come to know that this question you have to solve by following direct variation. Then you follow it. Therefore, 9 by 12 equals to x by 28. Or 12x equals to 9 into 28. Or x equals to 9 into 28 by 12. So it is coming how much? 28 cut by 4, it is coming 7, it is coming 3, and cut by 3, it is coming 3. So x equals to 21 centimeter. So actual length of model height will be 21 centimeter. Got the question? Now I'm coming to question number 7. Okay, question 7 has two parts. So here you see, suppose 2 kg sugar contain 9 into 10 to the power 6 crystals. How many sugar crystals are there in 5 kg and in 1.2 kg? So here also let the number of sugar crystal be x. So if the volume of the sugar is more, crystal molecule also more. If less, then it will be less. Okay. Let number of sugar crystal be x. So first one is make a box. This is what crystal and volume, crystal and weight. First one is what 2 kg and sugar crystal 9 into 10 to the power 6. You will have to write down 10 to the power 6 this way only. And if it contains 5 kg, this is x. So they vary directly. They vary directly to each other. You can write down this way also. Each other. So here calculation. Therefore, 2 into 9 into 10 to the power 6 equals to 5 by x. So you will calculate this way. So 2x equals to 5 into 9 into 10 to the power 6. You will not cut with 10 to the power 6. Or x equals to 5 into 9 into 10 to the power 6 by 2. Okay, cut, it will be 2.5. 2.5 and 9, it is coming how much? 2. You only multiply the whole number. It will be 22.5 into 10 to the power 6 crystal. Okay, crystals. 10 to the power, here there is a mistake, it is weight and this is crystal. You have to correct it. This is weight.
Wait. Crystal. Okay. Now same way, if I change the result, weight, crystal. So second question is, first part is same, 2 kg, 9 into 10 to the power 6 crystal. Now they are saying 1.2 kg, so volume is reduced, crystal number will also reduce. So therefore, 2 by 9 into 10 to the power 6 will be equals to 1.2 by x, or 2x equals to 9.9 into 10 to the power 6 into 1.2, or x equals to 9 into 10 to the power 6 into 1.2 by 2. By 2, cut, if I cut, it will be 0.6. 0.6 into 9 equals to x equals to 5.4 into 10 to the power 6 crystal. Okay, 10 to the power 6 crystal. So, note down it please. I am giving you remaining 3 questions as homework. Okay? I think you will be able to solve it. If not, you will inform me. I will do it in your class. Okay? Till then, bye bye students. Have a good day.